Aloha, I'm Chef Ryan Covert, and welcome to KTA Kitchens. Don't know what to do with your leftover corned beef and cabbage? Well, I have a great recipe for you. Let's get started with the ingredients. Our ingredients today is 1 9-inch deep pie shell, 1 cup of cooked corned beef, fat removed, 1 cup of hash browns, 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 2 cloves of garlic, 1 small onion, 2 cups of cabbage, 1 cup of Swiss cheese, 1 tablespoon of Dijon mustard, salt and pepper, 6 eggs, 1/2 cup of half and half, and some chives. The first step we want to do with this quiche is to saute the onions, cabbage, and garlic. So what we're going to do is add these to the pan, your olive oil, your minced garlic. Give that a little stir, break up the garlic. And then you add your onions. And then your cabbage. You're gonna wanna cook this for about 3 to 5 minutes until it's a little translucent. So once the cabbage and the onion mixture has cooked for about 3 to 4 minutes until it's nice and translucent, you wanna let it cool. And it has cooled, so we're now gonna add the other ingredients to this. So we're gonna add the corned beef, the potatoes, salt and pepper, the Dijon mustard, and then the Swiss cheese. And we're just gonna mix this together. Until it's nicely combined. So the next step is to do the egg part of the quiche. So we have 6 eggs. And then we add 1/2 cup of cream. And we add our chives. Let's mix that together. You want to make sure all the yolks and the egg whites have blended together with the half and half. Looks pretty good to me. So next step is to add the corned beef mixture to the pie crust. So go ahead and just put it into the bottom of the pie crust. And then we're going to add the egg mixture on top. You want to make sure that you pour the egg mixture slowly so it's evenly spread out. The next step, what I like to do is grab a fork and just kind of move everything around so the egg mixture gets into all the ingredients. Next, we're gonna bake this. So what I like to do is get a baking sheet, and I always like to line it with tin foil just because if it spills over, it's for easy cleanup. And now we place this into our oven at 375. The quiche has been cooking for about 40, 45 minutes. Now it's ready to take out the oven. Looks delicious. So the next step is to allow the quiche to cool for about 10 minutes before we cut into it. So now that the quiche has slightly cooled, I recommend pairing this quiche with that nice sparkling wine, champagne, or Prosecco. I'm Chef Ryan Covert, and thank you for joining me today in KTA Kitchens. Cheers. Mm-hmm.